What is a pipette? A pipette is a piece of volumetric glassware used to deliver an accurate and precise amount of solution. In your first year laboratory practicals, you will be learning how to use a pipette for your titration experiments. In this video, we will show you the correct way of using a pipette for your experiments. Using a pipette that was cleaned using the method described in the How to Clean Analytical Glassware, the pipette must be rinsed with the chemical solution before any solution is measured with the pipette. This is done by collecting a small quantity of the solution that is to be measured using the pipette in a clean beaker. The solution is then sucked up to approximately 2 to 3 centimeters above the graduation line, and the solution is expelled into your waste beaker. This procedure is repeated one more time. We recommend that a beaker be placed on your bench for any chemicals that you will no longer use during your experiment, which we refer to as the waste beaker. At the end of your practical, the waste in your beaker will then be discarded in the waste bottles in the lab. Once the pipette is rinsed, the solution is sucked up to about 2 to 3 centimeters above the graduation line by rolling the knob downwards, keeping the pipette tip well below the solution surface, but not allowing it to touch the bottom of the beaker as to prevent any air bubbles being sucked up. This is easily done by holding the pipette against the walls of the beaker. The solution level is then adjusted slowly by rolling the knob upwards on the probe pipette until the bottom of the meniscus is level with the graduation line. Make sure the graduation line is at eye level. The pipette is vertical and the tip of the pipette is touching the side of the beaker when lowering the meniscus. However, if the meniscus falls below the graduation line, the solution must then be sucked up again to about 2 to 3 centimeters above the graduation line, and the procedure on lowering the meniscus is repeated. This solution is drained into the conical flask by placing the tip of the pipette on the side of the flask and pressing the rectangular button on the probe pipette. On the bulb of the pipette, there is a value given after EX. This value represents the time that should be allowed to drain once the meniscus has stopped descending. This is an estimated time done by counting, allowing for slightly longer time than less time. For example, using the 20 milliliter pipette, it has an EX time of 15 seconds. However, if the pipette does not contain an EX time, assume the time is 15 seconds. The liquid that remains at the tip of the pipette should not be blown out into the flask. Do not touch the bulb of the pipette, as your body temperature will result in heating up the glass of the bulb, which will result in the glass expanding, altering the volume of solution delivered by the pipette. When collecting the solution to be pipetted, collect it in a clean beaker, making sure you collect the approximate amount of the solution that will be needed for the titration. For example, if you want to do 4 titrations, you need to pipette 20 milliliters for each titration. One should collect approximately 80 milliliters of the solution. If there is not enough solution for pipetting, one can always collect more solution, only getting the amount of solution you need. By following the steps that we have suggested in the video, you should be able to use your pipette correctly to transfer accurate volumes of liquids.